I'm going through a lot is what I say, but I have no excuse. I'm just saying, like, I'm sorry to all my black friends and families that are hurt, and my Muslim families that are hurt, and everybody that's, you know, affected by my words. I didn't mean no disrespect, and I feel really bad. I just, you know, I hit the switch, and it wasn't good, and some of my homies were hyping me up, you know, telling me, like, you know, say that word, bro, you got the pass, woody woo, and, you know, kind of just influencing me to, like, speak on black crime and what's going on in the community, and they kind of I ain't going to make no excuse. I'm not going to say they forced me. I ain't going to say none of that. I'm just saying, like, they were pushing it, too, and I'm not even trying to cap, like, you know, I'm not trying to even, like, be no weird shit. Like, I'm sorry, basically. But everybody knows I'm going through a hard time, and that's no excuse, and that's why I'm going to rehab and getting my shit, you know, handled. And, you know, I'm going through a lot, you know, a divorce, things happening to me all the time, matrix attacks all the time, and you guys may not believe it, but it's so fucking annoying that you got no fucking clue. Like, I wake up and I'm already, like, under some shit, and it's just like, bro, I'm over it, bro. I do stand on saying that, though. I don't like pedophiles, though. That I'm like, nobody's gonna change my mind. You're not gonna about to press me to make me think pedophiles are cool, bro. And that's point blank, period, bro. I don't care. I don't give a fuck. Like I said, I don't care if you're X, Y, and Z in any religion, in any, including Christians, bro. If you're a pedophile, you're weird to me. I'm calling everybody out, bro. I'm sorry, bro. That's weird, bro. That's weird. That's weird. You're never gonna change my mind. That's weird, bro. And Sneeko's the one that got me pissed off, because he's the one that came at Christianity. I'm saying that nobody defends Christians. We disrespect them and nothing happens. The Holy Spirit is woody woo. Bro, that's not cool, bro. Like, you got to be accountable for every action of yours. I know Muslims that would never disrespect Christianity like that ever. Bro, I know, like, that's just not right, bro. So he made me hit the switch. Like, I was mad. I was mad at Sneeko, and I feel bad for saying my stupid shit, but, bro, what is this problem, bro? I've always been nice. Bro, I was just in Dubai, and I was telling everybody, inshallah, I was friends with all my Muslim people. Dude, it was sick. Dude, I was at a fucking soccer game, and Muslim kids were coming up to me, pulling on my shirt, and I didn't care, bro. Nothing but love, bro. But, like, why does everybody get to talk shit about me? Like, why do I got to take everything? Tim Bradley fucking called me a fucking zoo animal live on ESPN, one of the biggest networks in the world. Bro, he called me a fucking zoo animal, bro. That's not cool. Like, where's my fucking justice, bro? Where's him? Why is he not getting canceled? Bro, that's not cool. You can't just call people zoo animals, bro, live on ESPN in front of the world, bro. That's not cool. Why does nobody care about my heart, bro? Like, why don't y'all care about what the fuck people say to me, bro? Call me a beaner and this, that, woody woo. I don't give a fuck, bro. I'm cool as fuck with all my homies, bro. All my black homies, all my Muslim people, everybody. Bro, Jewish, fuck everybody, bro. I'm cool with everybody. But, like, you're not about to be racist, bro. That's not cool, bro. Like, why is it Tim Bradley can't be racist, but see, I'm not even gonna say the black word anymore. I'm gonna just say Tim Bradley. I'm gonna start naming names, bro, because at the end of the day, bro, everybody's human, bro. I don't see color, bro. So Tim Bradley got to say I was a zoo animal. That's not cool, bro. And I apologize for my words on George Floyd and everybody that was hurt about that. I get it. I understand that. I was just speaking my piece because of what people have told me. They told me he was a crackhead. They showed me proof. They showed me he beat the shit. Oh, he had a pregnant lady at gunpoint, and he didn't like black people. He didn't even have a black girlfriend. The dude literally didn't stand for black people. I mean, what am I supposed to do, bro, when people are giving me dead-ass facts that he was a criminal and he had fentanyl in his system and he was literally drugged out? What am I supposed to do with that? Everybody's judging me, bro. Black people are telling me that, by the way. Black people are telling me, fuck George Floyd. I'm like, what? I didn't know what that meant. I was just like, what do you mean? Like, didn't he die by a police officer, like, unjustifiably? And they're like, nah, bro. Like, he died from an overdose. You know Candace Owens? Candace Owens said the same thing, bro. Mike Tyson literally said, I'm going to fuck you in the asshole, and I'm going to eat your children. Bro, but he's never canceled. Like, bro, why am I canceled for what, bro? Like, damn, I'm sorry. I'm never going to use that word again. Like, I don't care if I'm from the hood. I don't care if I get the pass, bro. I'm not listening to nobody no more, bro. You guys are weird, bro. I'm never going to listen to none of y'all no more. You guys don't try to hype me up saying you got the pass, bro. I don't got the pass, bro. Fuck y'all, bro, for telling me I had the pass, bro. I don't have no fucking pass. Obviously looking, bro, and now I'm in trouble.
Bro, you guys for the record, Ryan, I told you not to say it numerous times, but you know what? We've all been fucked up on shit, right? Or whatever the case may be. I know I have, right? Speaking from experience, and said some wild shit that I probably shouldn't have said, right?
Right.
But you know, you got to use better judgment, right? You know, in 2024, that shit you can't say. You're a smart dude, right?
Right.
You know, that's just shit you can't say. We try to tell you no, but, you know, obviously, when you're fucked up, I've been fucked up. Everyone in here has been fucked up and said some wild shit before.
Right.
So, you know, all we can try to do is get better and, you know, obviously apologize and do whatever you got to do. You know, we don't got the reach that you have on here, right?
All right.
You know, you got, what, you know, millions of followers, you know? So...
No, that's why when I, like, look back at it, bro, I shouldn't have hit the switch, bro. I feel bad, bro, because a lot of my black family members, like, they were literally calling me, like, bro, can't believe you said that. You hurt my heart. And I was like, damn. I was, like, feeling bad. Like, my mom's best friend is black. Her mom's,
It went too far. There's lines that were crossed. Now you know you don't have to do that anymore. The real people that care, nobody's perfect. The real people are still going to be here. Nobody's going to throw you in the trash. And I'm still going to help. But, hey, you don't got to do that anymore. Now you know what that feels like. It's going to be a road to redemption. Getting clean will help. I'll help any way I can. And that's it. You know, back to you. But unless you fire me, I got the band going. I got the band. And it's still the greatest show on earth. None of us would have written it this way. But here we are. So let's go. And we're here for you. And anybody that wants to throw hate, they can bring it to me. And the loyal people or whatever. But, hey, what the best for everybody. Back to you.
Like I said, I just want to be a positive influence now. Like I said, I'm headed to rehab. And I'm going to make a real change in my heart. And, like I said, all I can do is be better. I acknowledge that I definitely shouldn't have said those stupid shit. I was so fucked up that day. And I was thinking, it felt like I swear, bro, I know this is going to be funny, but a Call of Duty group chat. Bro, even your homies that are black, we hop in the group chat. Bro, everybody knows in the group chat we say stupid shit. Like, bro, I wish people y'all knew, like, in the group chat. Bro, people say some violating shit. Like, bro, like crazy stuff. And it's not funny. And I have a bigger responsibility now. But, again, I was majorly immature at that moment. And I understand I got my kids that look up to me, and I got a lot of little black kids looking up to me, Mexican kids looking up to me, and Muslim little kids, like, everybody looking up to me. So I just want to say sorry, and if I, like I said, if I hurt your heart, all I could do is say sorry, bro. I don't know what else to say. Like, actions speak louder than words, so all I'm going to do is show you that I'm going to be better. I'm not going to say no more stupid shit.
Facts.
Yeah. And even when people say stupid shit to me, like I said, I'm just going to turn the other cheek at this point. But again, it's still fuck pedophiles. I don't give a fuck. And that's it. So that's it. That's all I'm going to stand for. So if you ever hear me talk shit again, it's going to be against pedophiles. That's it. Other than that, hey, I'm going to be just shut the fuck up and be a better, you know, better example of what it is to be, you know, an athlete and somebody that, you know, wants to push all the communities forward, bro. I just want everybody to be happy, bro. I've seen the worst in everything, and it don't really matter. Like I said, I got to start naming people their names, bro. It ain't about if you're Mexican, black, white, brown, you know, anything, you know. It's just like, I'm going to name it by name. Like, yo, you're my friend Lawrence. You're not black, you're Lawrence, you know? Oh, and if he wants to say, oh, I'm black, you're black. See, I just want everybody to be happy, bro. I don't want everybody to be, like, you know, upset. And, again, like I said, I feel really bad. And I hope you guys understand my heart. Hey, I'm expelled from boxing, as I should be, you know, for my comments. And, hey, I don't get a box again, and I lost a lot of sponsorships. Like, I trust me, what I said is not going, you know, it's not going good for me, but I deserve it, you know, and I'm not trying to act like I don't deserve it, you know?
Mr. Garcia, you're the bad guy for all time, forever on the internet. But everybody loves the road to redemption. So we'll see. It ain't going to be easy, but your friends will be here for you. All right, back to you. That's all I wanted to say.
Thank you. Yeah, guys, like I said, I had it like after, man, I was so hurt. I was so mad at myself. I literally went to go train at like 12, 1 o'clock at night and I was very mad at myself. I couldn't believe it. I didn't even realize I said all that shit, to be honest. I'm being real with y'all. Like, I literally looked back and I was like, damn. That's fucked up. Like, why would I say that, bro? I was like, damn, I really said that? That's fucking nuts. Like, I really hit the switch. Like, I really got so mad, bro. Because I've been, like I said, I've been taking advantage of a lot of my life. And I think I just let my emotions get the best of me, for sure. And it wasn't towards anybody. You know what it was? It was towards the people that hurt me. It wasn't towards any individuals. Wasn't towards anybody in particular, you know? I've put on a lot of every race. I've put on a lot of races, you know? Shit, I literally helped out my best friend Lawrence become a professional fighter when he was going through a hard time. I took him in and he was black. I mean, and then I took in my Muslim friends and Mexican friends, black friends, white friends, every type of friend, bro. I don't really care. I just see the heart of people, and I'm like, man, they need love, or they need some, you know, they'll pick her upper. You know, everybody needs that sometimes. And again, man, I really feel bad. I really do, generally. And like I said, going to rehab, getting therapy, just trying to, like, work through my own traumas, and then I'm going to come back better, for sure.
Nobody can argue with that. Anybody got a problem with anything he just said? That's on you. Sorry. Nobody's perfect. It's tough, man. It's tough.
Yeah, and then, like, you got to add on top of everything. Like, again, no excuses, because I don't think I know what's going to happen. They're going to try to think I'm making excuses. I'm not. I'm literally taking acknowledgement for what I did. A lot of things are happening in my life, man. I feel falsely accused of doing steroids. They banned me from a sport that I love so much. Like I said, going through divorce, it's not fun to go through that. This is a lot. My mom has cancer. Matrix is always attacking me. And just my own mental struggles in itself. So, you know, it's not really fun for me. There's actually a lot more things that have happened to me that I'm not going to really get into. But this shit is just not fun, bro. Life is not fun, like right now. It's fun, but it's not, because it's like, I may be looking, oh, he's having a great time, Woody Woo, and things are going great, but they're really not, bro. I'm going to be real with y'all. Like, shit's just not fun, bro. Like, life is just not fun right now. Like, if you seen the shit I had to see and just, like, act like everything's all right, and then people are like, yo, you're crazy, you're a lunatic, you're a conspiracy theorist, woo-da-woo, you're a weird fucking right-winger. Like, just whatever they call me, bro. Like, I'm just like, bro, I literally have seen it. Like, what am I supposed to do, lie? Like, I don't want to lie, bro. Like, it's weird. It's like they want me to lie. I don't want to lie. But for some reason, they just say I'm lying. I'm just so sorry, man. Damn, I don't know how many, like, friends I have that are so hurt, bro. They call me and they're like, bro, how could you? I'm like, damn, bro. I feel bad. I just don't know. I don't know how to make it up to them. Like I said, actions speak louder than words at times.
Just one day at a time. Do simple steps, simple stuff. Don't try to do too much, right? It's the internet, man. We're all figuring this thing out. And don't let nobody else tell you any different. This ain't easy. This ain't easy.
It's not, bro. Especially in this day and age where everybody could have an opinion on you. And then they would just clip it and make it seem like there was no context behind it. And guess what? There is no excuse. So, yeah, you could clip that part. And guess what? Those words should never have been said.
That's facts. You just can't say some stuff. Sorry.
My friend was just hyping it up, man. He's the one that gave me the line of the ER word, and he was saying blah, 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 sends them to the ER. So why are you worried about blah, 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 ER? Bro, like, he was saying that, bro, for like if you listen to my other spaces, bro, he been saying that, bro. Like, I just repeated what he said. You understand what I'm saying? Like, I was just being dumb. I was drunk as fuck and just like, oh, well, I'm gonna copy what my friend said, like an idiot. Bro, I just was immature, bro. That was it. Facts. I was immature as fuck. I should have never said that stupid shit, and I regret it. And I do deserve all the shit that's happening at this point, for sure, 100%. Like, yeah, I should be expelled, for sure. What can I do, bro? I mean, I was already banned, so it just makes sense that I'm expelled now. So, you know, is what it is. But I do hope that everybody else gets held accountable, though. Hey, other people could be racist, too. Everybody could be racist. Doesn't matter the color of your skin. People could be racist, and I think it's time that people start acknowledging that, because the truth is the truth. And I think everybody needs to be held accountable if they're being racist. In every genre, in every, you know, every type of, you know, race. I really do. It should be acknowledged. It really should.
But again, I agree. You should. You know what you should do, Ryan? What? You should do a rehab vlog.
A rehab vlog?
A vlog, right? There are some nice rehab centers out there. I'm sure you can afford, right? When you go, and just vlog it, right? Day one.
I don't think they let you use your phone, if I remember right.
I mean, I'm sure there's some out there that will let you, right? Post it on YouTube, right. Make some money, get better, do better, and strive for, you know, being a better version of yourself, and make some money while you do it. You know what I mean? That's what I would do. Vlog it.
Right. I mean, again, at this point, I ain't really worried about the money. I'm just worried about getting better. I'm really hurting my family and everybody around me, and they're freaking out, and everybody's freaking out, bro. None of what I said reflects anything my family thinks, bro. They're all mad at me. They're not talking to me at all. So it's like, you know, it is what it is. I can't even go to my brother's fight. He doesn't want me to go. So just don't take it out on them. They're innocent, you know? Those are my words and not theirs, and I want everybody to know that, because I can't even go to my brother's fight, so it is what it is.
Getting clean is a good first step, and that'll be a loud message to everybody. I've been sober for over a year. I don't know if people know that. So, from alcohol, but I'm just saying, that's a good first step. We can all agree. Well, it's a simple thing where we can make a good thing out of this mess and move on. Back to you.
Okay, well, I gotta go, guys.
I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
I'm Ellie Seckback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.